Today is Earth Day, an event that began in 1970 and is often considered the beginning of the modern environmental movement. This year, the issue at the top of the agenda is plastic. From grocery bags to plastic straws to tiny microbeads and everything from soap to makeup, the Earth is swamped in plastic and will remain so for generations to come. So what can be done? Joining me now is Jenna Jambeck, Associate Professor of Environmental Engineering at the University of Georgia, who is marking this Earth Data Conference and joins us from Tel Aviv. Thanks for being with us. So let's kind of put this in perspective. What's the scale of our plastic problem or situation?
In 2015, we were able to estimate the input of plastic from our mismanaged waste around the world into the oceans, and that is equal to about 8 million metric tons of plastic entering the oceans every year. So if you think about it, that's equal to about a dump truck of plastic every minute going into the ocean. It's very significant.
And is there anything that we know about plastic that gives us any kind of hope? I mean, how long does it take for plastic to dissolve or degrade as it sits in our oceans?
It really doesn't ever biodegrade that we're aware of. And what it does instead is fragment over time into smaller and smaller pieces. So a large plastic item then ends up as many small microplastic items.
And these microplastics, I'm assuming they end up inside aquatic life because they think it's food?
Certainly, some of this looks very much like food that animals in the marine ecosystem eat. And then we know that even some of the smallest items, like some of the microbeads, can be consumed by some of the smallest animals in our food web, like zooplankton.
When you think about a dump truck of plastic every minute, what is the impact that you and I can have, or any human being can have, on that kind of quantity? What are steps that we can actually take that reduces that?
Reusable water bottle, reusable coffee mug, don't use a straw, a reusable bag. I know we've heard them before, but our research really shows that taken collectively, or you just making this choice over a period of time, those choices really have an impact.
And is there agreement around the planet? I mean, you see local communities decide to, say, ban plastic shopping bags or charge higher for them. Has the world started to figure that out, especially in developing countries?
Yeah, I mean, I think we're all at different stages around the world, and many of these solutions are very locally based. But at the same time, yes, I think we can all around the world agree that we don't want plastic in our environment, in our oceans. The UN has a campaign, and folks around the world can sort of state their commitments that they're having to help with this issue. And so they might be different, but everyone can commit to doing something.
Are there any technologies on the horizon that might be good substitutes for plastics that might be less harmful to the planet in the long term?
We're looking at polymers at the University of Georgia and the New Materials Institute that will biodegrade, actually biodegrade, but also serve some of the needs of plastic. So you can think of something more like a paper. Of course, these things still need to be managed within our waste stream, but I do think that thinking about new materials and product design is a very important step that's way upstream of thinking about solving this problem.
All right, Jenna Jambeck, Associate Professor of Environmental Engineering at the University of Georgia, joining us on Earth Day. Thanks so much.
Happy Earth Day.